everybody. So it's still Friday, as you can tell, because I'm wearing the same get-up that I was this morning. Oh, I'm so glad it's Friday. Yes, I wasn't giving you a kiss. I wasn't drooling all over you. I was drooling all over my vlog sponge. Because it can handle it. Because it's a spongy sponge, you see? And that's what sponges do. They absorb things. In particular, liquid things. Like drool. Anyway. Oh, I've had so much vlog ammo in the last couple of weeks, and now that I've got my camera back, I've got other things to talk about. Things are well, first of all. Things are well. The underbelly of the house, Andy, doesn't look like an underbelly anymore. It's coming along. And I know I'm gonna die of heat, but I've gotta roll the window up because I'm tired of fighting with traffic. Yes, the underbelly of the house, that god-awful room that I showed you that we dug out, is actually looking more like a room now than ever. So later on, maybe over the weekend, I'll put together a video and I'll show you guys what that looks like. I won't bore you with the details right now. I wanted to talk about quickly a show that I saw on the telly the other day. Yeah, I actually had the opportunity the other day to watch after work Oprah Winfrey. I did. And the topic somewhat blew me away. Well, it was a portion of the topic that blew me away. Oprah was doing a show on the FLDS ranch in Arizona. Yes, there is a Latter-day Saints Zion ranch in Arizona that was in the news some time ago. They were raided because they were suspected of polygamy, which of course you know is illegal in the United States, and they were also being accused of molesting and abusing children. So they raided the ranch and they took all the children away, and that was the news story. And Oprah Winfrey decided she wanted to visit the ranch to see what these people really lived like, and I guess to try to get to the bottom of these allegations. The part that blew me away, aside from the polygamy and all of that stuff, was this. She asked the second graders what they do for fun. And their answer was, we work. Work is fun. And that blew me away. It did. She then continued to poke them and ask them, you know, if they played any games, and they said no, they weren't interested in having fun. That is just totally bizarre to me, because I'm nearly 30 years old and I cannot imagine living my life without fun. I'd blow my brains out. I really would. Because fun, for me, is what relaxes me. It's what levels me out, and it's what helps, well, it's what helps ground me when I feel overwhelmed with the amount of work that I have to do. it really does help me out a lot. You know, you have to sometimes be able to let loose and just do something that is not work oriented. I mean, you know, it can be in a sense work, like if it's a hobby or a project, like painting or building a model or something, but to be brought up in such a way that you don't recognize what fun is, to me, is absolutely absurd. Alright, I'm gonna go in there now and do some more pondering about this, because my brain is so twisted on this subject that I know I have more to say, but I cannot get it out right now. So I'm gonna ponder it more. I wanted to come on and ask you what your thoughts were of children that are not interested in having fun. Genuinely, they're not interested. Work is fun. Living on the commune is fun. Farming is fun. School is fun. But they don't play games, they don't watch movies, they don't watch TV. But they all have iPods and cell phones. Which was even more twisted to me. I can't wrap my head around it, and I'm hoping that somebody else can help me try to understand how one lives in life without yearning for some relaxation or some fun. What's the definition of work and play, and where do we draw the line, I guess? You know? Yes, we can enjoy our work. I'm not saying that that cannot be fun. But sometimes you need to play and have it not involve anything else that has to do with responsibility. You know? Sometimes play has to be kept separate from responsibility. At least for me. What are your thoughts? Let me know. It's Friday and I'm going inside to have a brewski. Yes. My second waffle is quite a waffle. I'm so discombobulated. And now I'm sweating. That's why I have a vlog sponge. Alright guys, I'll see you later. Enjoy your Friday night, and yeah, it's good to be back. I'll see you later.